Oh Lord, give me strength. Share the truth. And wake as many as I can up. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Friends, family, worthless Klingons and trolls. I just had a little conversation with a couple of people regarding this video here. Navy to charge officer for shooting Islamic extremist. And in the end, I felt inspired to do another video because there's so many people that are asleep still. And apparently this Navy new lieutenant commander reportedly is going to be charged for firing back at a Chattanooga terrorist. Apparently he had his own weapon, and it was a good thing. And so now the Navy's talking about charging him because he's not supposed to have weapons, which I think is ridiculous, because who better to have weapons than people that are trained to have them? So it doesn't say much about our various government policies, does it? But, you know, I do have issues with that, because they want these guys to be sitting ducks. They want to put them in harm's way, yet when they get killed and are wounded, there's no support for their families or medical support for them. I have a daughter that's a Marine, a disabled Marine veteran, and she was injured seriously, and she needs a hip replacement. She's a young lady, about 30 years old, and they basically made her a drug addict. They openly admit she needs a hip replacement, but they say, well, it only lasts 20 years, so, you know, meds are the way to go, and so we'll have to do it again another 20 years if we did it, so it's too expensive. So they, last time I counted, she was on 8 different meds, including psychotropics, so it's really messed her up. And so, obviously, I've got some bias when it comes to how they treat our veterans. So, with that said, I just had a little discussion here regarding this article that, or video that Alex Jones did. I know a lot of people, you know, badmouth Alex, but a lot of people do support him. I happen to be a supporter. Do I agree with everything he says? No, of course not. I'm sure he doesn't agree with everything I say. But that's just our right to agree to disagree. But I got to give kudos where kudos are due. So, I had made a comment on this video that said, I agree 100%. This should be a clear warning to all active duty military personnel to leave the military as soon as possible. It's a no-brainer. In other words, if they want our military to be sitting ducks and not and be in a position to where you know, they can't defend themselves, I mean, that's crazy. That's suicide. Who in their right mind would accept a mission like that? You know, the outcome only leads to your own demise. I mean, who benefits by you dying? Certainly not your family and children. So I think that anybody's in the U.S. military at this point, and I'm not anti-military, don't get me wrong. I'm not. I'm not anti-U.S. government. I'm anti-U.S. corruption in the government, or I'm anti, you know, corruption in the U.S. government. But I'm all for the right to defend yourself and a strong military. But at the same time, I'm also pro Second Amendment, you know. And so anyway, getting to the comment here, that kind of set me off, and maybe want to do another video, is I had this guy comment, and he said, Oh, has he removed it? Well, maybe it's another video. I don't know. Give me just a second. I apologize. It might be another video. So I will take a look. Oh, yes, it is another video. I apologize, folks. This video was a global stock market crash has begun. So let me get back to one of the main emphasis I wanted to make on this in this video I'm making. This fella was trying to say that there's not troops, running up and down the streets of America, and I've seen videos of that actually happening just a few blocks away from where I used to live. And so I made a comment to that effect, and he writes back and says it's fiction. So this is what he says. It's like, check this out. You're not going to believe this. He says, using YouTube as proof of anything is like using comic books to learn about life on Earth. And if they are, it's probably some National Guard training. I was active for 13 years. We hardly ever train off base. So no troops are running up and down the streets. Too bad we can't hold people liable and actionable for the BS they put out on these channels. Never know, maybe someday. Well, he knows how to hit my buttons because that's a veiled threat. Okay, and I'm the wrong guy to threaten. Okay, you see, I still have a set. So my reply to him was, oh, rest assured that there will be an accountability or an accounting. No doubt about that. But the problem is, some folks that think they're going to get away with things are going to end up in hell's fire. Big surprise coming for many. So do stay tuned. And as for one attending, or excuse me, as for one attacking the medium on which information happens to be disseminated, same has no bearing on the truth. Only a brainwashed sock puppet would even consider same as fact. Please note, as one example, that a Bible verse that is valid if it's written on the pages of the good book right here is just as valid if it's written on the wall of a restroom stall. So have a nice day. And that's the truth. The truth is the truth. And it doesn't matter if the truth comes via YouTube or TV or radio or the neighbor across the street telling you. The truth is the truth. So trying to attack the media or medium is just ridiculous. So, he writes back and says, there's no troops running up and down the streets. And I wrote back and I said, ever heard of Jade Helm? I said, how about Walmart's being closed and converted? I said, how about FEMA camps? How about all 800 of them? I said, how about 23,000 plus so-called pastors that are on FEMA's payroll? I said, do you live under a rock? I said, what are you, paid opposition? I said, inquiring minds would like to know. So, I don't think he replied after that. It's probably a good thing. And here's another guy. He said, Alex is always wrong. The point is, Alex is not always wrong. I told him, I says, what about the Obama deception? Was he wrong about the Obama deception? And we got a guy that, you know, they put out a fake birth certificate. Fake, red alert, fake. And how's this guy still sitting in the office? I don't get it. Why aren't there people walking around, marching around the White House with pitchforks and ropes? I don't get it. I really, truly don't get it. And how's Congress putting up with this? I smell blackmail. That's what I smell. You know, how is it that these, you know, these people that supposedly represent us are tolerating this? How can they go in there and vote, you know, contrary to what the public wants? It's amazing. So, you know, we live in a day and age where so many people see what's going on and don't want to get involved, and basically apathy is killing the country. And then there are those that just stick their head in the sand. They don't want to see it, period. They just don't. So, and, you know, then the representatives that we pay to represent us don't represent us. They represent big business, corporations. You know, it's cheap for a corporation to give pay off a politician, give them $100,000 or $1 million when they make billions. It's just the cost of doing business. And people need to wake up. I was a businessman for many years. I've had it all. Okay, I've had the yachts, I've had the Corvettes, I've had the women, I've had it all. I'm telling you, it's just like Solomon said, in the end, it's all meaningless. Okay? So people need to wake up and understand what the priorities in life are about. You know, we're here to glorify God and serve Him, not ourselves. And that's what these politicians are doing. They're serving themselves. And, you know, the good book here, the Bible, says that cowards aren't going to make it to heaven. So if you're not getting up and taking a stand, guess what? I don't care how much you profess to believe in Jesus, you will not go to heaven. It's written. It's written. It's in the book. You won't make it. Okay? So, you know, we all have a cross to bear. And the servant certainly isn't greater than the master. And so, you know, this video is to encourage you to get up and do your very best and get the truth out. Because, you know, the life you save may be your own as well as the own, you know, that of your family. So, you know, with that said, I'd just like to thank you for listening. And if you're hanging around, you know, the U.S., you might want to think about leaving. Because the Word says she's going to burn. And different prophets have said the same thing. David Wilkerson, Henry Gruver. And, you know, so, Dimitri Dudeman, same thing. She's going to burn. So in the mouth of, you know, two or more witnesses, may every word be established. It's established. It's happening. The writing's on the wall. You got to be blind not to see this. So if you want to get out and you feel led to get out and you feel like the Lord's calling you out, you know, you want to go east, we're in the Philippines. Perhaps we can help you. Some people go into South America. You know, personally, that's not for me. But, you know, other people are heading to the hills. They got bug-out locations away from the cities. I suggest that maybe you consider that if you can't leave the country. That's okay. You know, if God tells you to stay, stay. But I'm just trying to do my best to help the brothers and sisters out there the best I can. And but if you do want to leave and you need some coaching and counseling, I can help you, you know, come in this direction. All you got to do is just go to my website or, you know, go to your search bar here and just type in Flee Babylon. It's that simple. .com. Hit enter. And it will bring up our site. And, you know, you read all about it and then pray about it and see if that's what God wants you to do. But do something And by all means, support people that are out here fighting. Not the Joel Osteens, you know, that are called in sock puppets and called into, you know, Larry King Live. And he's asking, well, what do you think about homosexual marriage? And, you know, he says, well, you know, Larry, that's not my window. I'm all about love. And, you know, but you know what David Wilkerson said? People are using love as an excuse. They're getting rid of love, the devil. He says that all they do is quote, you know, cliches. It has nothing to do with the Word of God. So, you know, I get that sometimes on some of my posts and some of my videos. Jesus is all about love. Yeah, he is about love. But he's also the most fierce warrior you can imagine. You think for 1 minute he's not stronger than the strongest angel in heaven? Think. What he did and how he allowed himself to be crucified. And he flat said, nobody takes my life from me. I lay it down. He's tough. He's tougher than you can even imagine. Okay? So you expect to be tough too. Okay? No cowards. There's no room for cowards. Don't lie to yourself and don't lie to other people. Get real. Get in the game. Support people that are getting the job done, are doing their best to get the job done. You know, we're out here doing our very best, trying to wake people up, trying to turn people away from Catholicism. We got a church down the street with the Eye of Horus right over the front door, same Eye of Horus that's on your dollar bill. Okay? And they don't have a clue. They think it's the Eye of God. So we're out here doing our very best. We get little to no support. Okay? So, you know, if God's telling you to support somebody, consider us. If not, support somebody else. Maybe you don't like me. Maybe you don't like my beard. Maybe you don't like my hat. Maybe you don't like my message. Okay? But support somebody. Somebody. Anybody. Okay? Do something. Maybe you don't tithe. But support somebody. All right? But if you will, and you feel led, support us. You need a Bible? We sell Bibles. Okay? Every little thing that we can do, you know, to make a dollar, to try to, you know, wake people up here, that's what we're trying to do. So you can go to our website, again, Flee Babylon, look around, tells you all about what we're doing, what we're trying to accomplish. If you're a missionary, you're looking for a place to serve, come on down. We got housing for you, okay? We'll do our very best. Let's get the word out. Let's try to wake as many people up before Christ comes back. He will come back. I'm not a pre-tribber, okay? But I think something's going down pretty soon. This September thing is all over the place. And one simply can't deny, you know, how many times this September, you know, date, 23rd, 24th, is popping up in the movies. This is mind-blowing. But I'm not predicting a pre-trib rapture. I'm not a pre-tribber. I don't hate people that are pre-tribbers. It's not a salvation issue. But I just think a lot more things have to happen. And I think we're going to go through the tribulation. You know, my Bible says in Matthew 13 that, you know, the tares are taken first. And then after that, then his wheat is gathered into the barn. Okay? It also says that we're not going anywhere until the last trump. The last trump. Okay? Now, we may not be appointed to wrath, but that doesn't mean we won't go through tribulation. So, anyway, with that said, love you. I'm doing everything I can do. Support us if you can, if you will. And if you can't support us, do something for somebody. At least share your faith. Because there's going to be an accounting. There's going to be an accounting. And are you a profitable servant? We're going to find out. And by the way, that's real thunder. So, you take care. Love you. Bye now.